Hello and welcome to Blockchain Central. 2019 was not so easy of a year for the crypto industry. It was filled with ups and downs, loud presentations, and unfulfilled hopes. Let's take a look back at the most significant events that have affected the market as a whole and Bitcoin in particular. Rally and Bitcoin drop. Bitcoin met this year in not so good position. According to the coin market cap on January 1st, 2019, its price equaled $3,760. However, everything changed later this spring as the market turned around and BTC began to rise in price, pulling other coins with it. Participants of the crypto community were jubilant, and experts associated the leap with algorithmic trading. The rally lasted all spring, and in early summer, the trend was supported by news about the imminent release of the Libra cryptocurrency from Facebook. Bitcoin reached its annual maximum on July 10th, breaking the $13,000 mark. Then there was a recession, and by the end of the summer, the cryptocurrency dropped to $10,000. In the fall, Bitcoin continued to, fall, briefly surpassing the $10,000 milestone, only to crawl down again. On October 24th, it was trading at less than $7,500. The trend turned around after the adoption of the cryptocurrency law in China, and on October 29th, BTC exceeded the mark of $9,500. However, China quickly made it clear that it is friendly towards blockchain technology, but not cryptocurrencies. In general, in the first half of the year, Bitcoin rose in price by more than 300%. Which is associated with hopes for the legalization of cryptocurrencies. However, under pressure from regulators, by the end of the year, Bitcoin has lost its position again. Failures of the year. The ups and downs accompanied not only Bitcoin, but other cryptocurrency projects as well. Let's see which of them failed and could not meet the expectations of investors. Bakkt launch. The crypto community was really looking forward to the launching of Bakkt platform, suggesting that the platform could change the whole industry for the better. Hopes were associated with the arrival of institutional investors on the market. Unfortunately, everything did not work out as planned. Bakkt officially launched on September 23rd. However, the 24 hours showed that the day trading volume of $710,000 on the platform indicated a lack of broader interest. Despite its unsuccessful launch, Bakkt is still trying to stabilize. New York State Department of Financial Services gave permission for institutional investors worldwide to access custodial solutions. Another step towards the expansion of services was the launch of regulated options for Bitcoin and future contracts with fiat settlements. As a result, the daily volume of contracts traded on Bakkt even reached $43 million for some time. The situation still remains unstable, but in any case, the appearance of the platform is a new round in the history of the crypto industry. Deferred Libra launch. The release of the Libra cryptocurrency from Facebook was announced on June 18th. On the same day, the project published its white paper. The crypto community reacted positively to the news, and Bitcoin began to rise sharply in price. However, the hopes that Libra would be launched as the creators planned in the summer of 2020 quickly melted away. The reason for this is the pressure of the international regulators. It resulted in PayPal, MasterCard, Visa, eBay, Stripe, Booking, and Mercado Libre leaving the project one after another. In the following statement to the U.S. House of Representatives Committee of Financial Services, Mark Zuckerberg said that the Libra would not be launched anywhere in the world until it was approved by regulators. Canaan IPO failure. The cryptocurrency mining giant Canaan held an IPO on the NASDAQ on September 20th. It was not as successful as expected. Initially, when the company applied for an IPO to the U.S. Securities and Exchange Commission, the SEC, it expected to raise $400 million. Just a few days before the landmark event, the bar fell to $100 million, but even this mark could not be reached. During the auction, 10 million shares were sold at $9 per share, which allowed Canaan to raise $90 million. As a result, the securities of the Chinese company collapsed on December 13th by 40%, which may be due to the sinking of Bitcoin. Experts do not exclude that the decline may continue if Bitcoin does not begin to grow. OneCoin cryptocurrency pyramid. Despite the fact that there is a lot of scam in the crypto industry, the OneCoin pyramid stands out from the rest. The amount that victims voluntarily invested in it reached $5 billion. The scheme of the pyramid turned out to be standard. To get a reward, you need to bring a friend. And nevertheless, they believed in it. People even bought the mythical OneCoin cryptocurrency. The scam network covered the countries of Europe, Africa, Asia, and Latin America. Despite the fact that OneCoin had been rumored to be dangerous since 2016, Active measures were only taken in 2019, when the New York Southern District Attorney's Office charged the head of the company, Konstantin Ignatov, who was later arrested at the Los Angeles airport. He pleaded guilty to certain charges and may be in prison for up to 90 years. The project lawyer Mark Scott was found guilty of laundering $400 million. However, Ruja Ignatova, the founder of the pyramid and the third suspect, could not be found. Graham launched Pause. Another company that fell out of favor with the U.S. Securities and Exchange Commission turned out to be Telegram, which planned to release its Gram cryptocurrency on October 31st. Through trial, the regulator blocked the TON project and the sale of its tokens in the United States, arguing that the decision was unlawful for an ICO, during which the company managed to raise $1.7 billion. Also, the commission believes that the Gram falls within the definition of a security. The company's founder, Pavel Durov, said in a letter to his investors that his team had been trying to get clarification from the SEC about the project for a year and a half, but to no avail. It came as a surprise to him that the regulator decided to suspend the project just before its launch. As a result, the founder of Telegram was summoned to the District Court of the Southern District of New York to testify in early January 2020. The meeting, which should decide the legal status of Gram, is planned to be held in February, despite the fact that the TON project is now under the watchful eye of regulators. The developers continue to work on it and have already submitted a test version of the wallet. Pavel Durov hopes that he will be able to resolve all issues with the SEC and launch the project in April 2020. And now for some good things that happened. Cryptography Act in China. China adopted the law on cryptography on October 26, and it came into force on January 1st, 2020. In addition, the country's leader Xi Jinping called the Communist Party to consider blockchain as the main technology for innovative breakthroughs and to give it all kinds of support. This news encouraged the market, and as a result, it went up. However, the Chinese authorities pretty quickly made it clear that their friendly attitude exclusively concerns blockchain and not cryptocurrencies in general. Some experts believe that introducing cryptography into the legal field was a preparation for creating a national digital coin, which would allow the country to gain control over financial flows. One way or another, China seeks to gain leadership in the crypto industry until the United States or other countries do so. Blockchain integration and JP Morgan banking system. The financial giant JP Morgan was one of the first to evaluate the benefits of the blockchain by creating its own Quorum blockchain and the International Information Network, designed for data exchange based on Ethereum. The idea of a payment platform appealed to many participants of the financial market, and 360 banks have already joined the IIN network, including Deutsche Bank, which is the world leader in the volume of clearing operations in Euro. In addition, 80 Japanese banks are also planning to join the IIN in the near future. This will allow participants of the platform to exchange data faster, increase the verification efficiency, and accelerate transactions. The rapid development of the JP Morgan project suggests that the blockchain has found its audience in the banking sector. Permissions to trade cryptocurrencies for banks in Germany. From January 1st, 2020, a law was introduced in Germany that allows banks to sell, buy, and store digital assets. Despite the fact that the country is categorically opposed to the Libra project from Facebook and is worried about the private cryptocurrencies, it still allowed banks to make transactions with them. Apparently, Germany is counting on creating favorable conditions for the development of the crypto industry. However, at the moment we're talking about permission to work with digital assets exclusively for banks, but not for individuals. As we can see, the crypto industry had one of the most controversial years. Though, 2019 showed that blockchain is becoming more and more accepted by big corporations and even countries. 2020 is already here, and we cannot wait to see what it's got in store for us. Thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, make sure to hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe to Blockchain Central to never miss a beat. Before you go, please note that this content does not represent financial, legal, or tax advice, nor is it supposed to be understood or interpreted as solicitation to buy or sell any securities, coins, or tokens. See you in the next one.